I play a character as a real guy named Jack Brennan. He was a Marine and was stationed at the White House. And Nixon kind of befriended him. Nixon was very fascinated, I think, and kind of enthralled with Marines. I think possibly, you know, saw maybe thought that was a kind of man that he wishes he was, you know, someone who would be able to make it through boot camp and, you know, go to war. And he, when he left and resigned from the White House, he asked Jack to come with him and become his chief of staff. They were very close. They spent a lot of time together, played a lot of golf together. And he was fiercely loyal to Nixon. I'll tell you what happened was I got the screenplay and read the screenplay, and it just so happened that I had tickets to go see the show that night. So I was, you know, thrilled to see the performances and already had sort of a frame of reference of where the screenplay was going, because it was, you know, quite a bit different than the Broadway show. I think that Peter did a great job opening it up and taking a piece of theater and turning it into a piece of cinema. That's true. Yeah, that's true. I for whatever reason, they don't really come back around too often. Well, I'm not that hard to work with. I don't know what it is, but there's only maybe him and Barry Levinson, I guess. Yeah. Well, I've had an opportunity to work with a lot of really, you know, incredible directors. That's been great. Young, old, you know, male, female, first timers, and you know, people who've done, you know, a lot of pictures. So I've been really lucky in that way. No, not really. You know, I don't go back and look at them. So my memories of films are often more have to do with the making of it. You know, not so much the film itself. So I don't really categorize them in that kind of way.